And now, the way it used to be, here's Joey. Vegas All Net Radio, the final frontier of free speech.
Views and opinions expressed on this program are those of the hosts and guests and do not necessarily reflect those of Vegas All Net Radio, its affiliates, or its parent company.
And now, here's Joey Jacoby.
Everybody, how you doing? Happy Friday. It's the weekend time. So happy that you're with me today on this November 6th. Yeah, so I just kind of want to start out, friends. First of all, I just want to just wish my dad a happy birthday that's no longer with us anymore. So, it's kind of a rough day for me, but, I'm always about heart. So shout out to Dad up there. Blessings. We're going to do a song that I wrote for him when he passed away at the end of this segment. Anyway, want to say hello to our new sponsors. Don't get too excited. You might get one after a little bit. I don't know. These are just ideas, okay? All right. I want to talk about a place called Pink Box Donuts. John, you ever heard of it before? It's the bomb. It's the greatest place, all right? Pink Box Donuts, all right? They're located where? Lake Mead, right? And in Henderson. All right. And I want to get you those addresses here a second. But right now they're my new sponsors. John, you gotta look at these, right? We gotta check that out. That's some good stuff there, right, baby? Yeah. Helen, you know you like the apple fritter, all right? So I wanna do a shout out to Pink Box and thank them for sponsoring us and it was perfect. Mention the Joey Ciccone show, you get free coffee. That's at the Lake Mead location. Okay, so if you go in there, you get the coffee. It's beautiful. Okay, free. You pay for the donut, pal. All right, just to let you know. Now I want to talk about my other lovely sponsors. Okay. Put these on. I'm happy. We're getting sponsors here at our lovely station. Innovative Care Physician Group. Dr. Goldsmith, as owner and CEO of Prime Care, has developed a revolutionary program that utilizes a combination of medications, supplements, diet, and behavior modification to create patient-specific plans for successful weight loss. Excuse me. Real doctors, real people, real weight loss. It's a really good place. It's 702-878-8888. By the way, while you're losing weight, there's Reva Faye. She's an RN. She'll make you look beautiful, you know. She'll make you look handsome, you know. All right? With some skin analysis to improve your skin texture, fillers, Botox, safe chemical peels, and enhance a well-rounded menu of services for your mind, body, and gentle addresses that issues of anti-aging from hormone supplements with medical DNA testing and wellness goals. Stay tuned. That's my new sponsor. They're going to be carrying a lot of weight here. I have a little toast here. Carrying a lot of weight for us, and we're going to really endorse them, so I kind of wanted to get that out of the way. Some things I just wanted to talk about, you know, the casinos. I went into the casinos. Did you know that you are going to have to pay to valet park? Okay, I don't know what you think about that. Personally, I don't really care for it. Give me a call at 702-483-4444. I just want to tip the guy. I want to park my car. I want to tip the guy. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to pay for it, which we kind of got stuck the other night for like $20. Okay? And I don't want to say where it was, okay? But we had to pay $20 to get the car. Okay? Am I right? Yeah, it wasn't pretty. It wasn't pretty. So with that being said, you know, I was thinking about some some things that came to mind about just people in general. You walk into the casino, it's not like how are you, Miss Carr? Nice to see you again. You know, and they took care of you and they did things, which we talk about all the time, right? On the way it is. But the bottom line is, you don't get that customer service anymore. You don't get it at any store. And I love this when people say, you know, things are changing. Things are changing. My friends, things have already changed, okay? We have a new group of basically our kids are going to be stepping into, you know, things we're doing. And that's what's going to be running the world for a while here, right? So it's just the way with the respect and all these things, I just really don't care for too much, you know? So with that being said, these are just some of my thoughts today that I'm coming up. But we're happy to have Pink Box. We're happy to have the innovative physicians care. We love having them. And, you know, I got a real special guest coming up here with me today that gentleman has been around a long time. We kind of got reacquainted again, and you know, it was really nice to get to visit and be asked to be on one of his shows. He's done some marvelous things, which we'll be talking about, and you'll see. But the bottom line is, just did a nice little show the other night, and my friend will explain that. Tony Saka in the house. Okay, all right. That's all I need to say. Tony's going to be with here with us shortly in the next 15 seconds. I don't know, 15 minutes, somewhere around there. But I think I want to lay that song on him, you know, for my dad. I think I'd like to do that. Okay, so, we're in the case there. John's going to get it. It's a song called Dad's Song. It's a song I wrote for my dad. Thanks, John. Appreciate that. There you go, bud. Come on, just grab it up. Thank you. Got roadies here, everybody. All right. Okay. This is going to go out to my dad, Carmine. Pop, happy birthday. Just say so long until that time meet again. You're forever in my song. I won't say goodbye. I'll just say so long until that time we meet again. You're forever in my song. I close my eyes and you're with me. I open them and you're gone. Life don't seem forever. Your spirit had to move on. It's okay. That's what you would say. You gotta hang in there, son. You gotta be strong. Well, there's nothing in life that I can give you back, but your words are in my song. I won't say bye-bye. I just say so long. Till that time we meet again, you're forever in my song. All right. I won't say bye-bye. I'll just say so long. Until that time we meet again, you're forever in my song. You're forever in my song. Your voice is in my song. Gonna be right back with my special guest, entertainer, host, entrepreneur, Mr. Tony Saka. You're forever in my song.
Las Vegas is the greatest town in the world. It's the entertainment capital of all capitals in the universe.
Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft. But then his number came up and he was gone with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowing reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
Would you like to swing on a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar. And be better off than you are. Or would you rather be a mule?
Baby, baby, it looks like it's going to hail. Baby, baby, it looks like it's going to hail. Won't you come inside and let me teach you how to jive and wheel? Whoa, you gotta jump, jive.
Then you ain't gotta jump, jive. Then you ain't gotta jump, jive. Then you ain't gotta jump, jive. Then you ain't gotta
jump, jive. Oh, the Shark, babe. In the old days when I started here 40 years ago, this was never Sin City. It was run by some good guys, and it was a lot of shows with women and big with women, and there were no kids and no families. But that's what Vegas was about.
Is there such thing as the mob, Joe?
The mob?
What mob?
Was that a show? A Vegas show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a Vegas show.
With the girls?
Yeah.
I'd be there.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come on, fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll tune his flute for you. Come on, fly with me, let's take off in the blue.
Uh-huh. That's life.
That's life.
That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune. When I'm back on top in June.
neon's flashing and the one I'm about that's crashing. All those hopes down the drain. People in Las Vegas turning day in the nighttime, turning night in the daytime. If you see it once, it'll never be the same again. Brand new beat. Summer's here and the time is right. We'll be dancing in the street. All we need is music, sweet music. There'll be music everywhere. There'll be swing and swaying, a record playing, a dancing in the street.
Fire.
Trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, shibby-dibby-doo, this is a wonderful world.
You are my guest in the very best town. The streets are so bright, whether day or night. This is the place where you can set.
We're very, very lucky to have a very special person who is really our ambassador for entertainment, my good friend, Tony Sackett. Tony is really the ambassador, and he's about to sing a great song. I got to tell him, really, it is my favorite. Las Vegas, the greatest town around.
So wherever you go, you will always know that there's no other place like Las Vegas. It's a sun town. It's the kind of town where people win all around. It's Las Vegas, Las Vegas, the greatest town around.
Everybody, how you doing? Joey Ciccone back with you. The way it used to be. Oh, you got to check it out. You got to love the man next to me right here. Tony Sacca in the house here. Ooh. Vegas All Net Radio, Joey Ciccone Show. I got my other new friend over here. Well, Mr. Rob Garrett. All
Ron
right.
Garrett.
Don't call me Rob.
Ron.
Nice. Oh, Ron?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Ron Garrett. Rob Garrett is the.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. It's a little joke. Don't worry about it. Anyway, look. This is Tony's book right here. Tony Sacca, Las Vegas Ambassador of Entertainment. All right. Tony, I got to get right into it. All right.
Get right into it.
We start talking and everything. The bottom line is this. All right.
Bada bing, bada boom.
How did it all start, man? Come on. Nice and easy. We start. You have a little water if you need it.
How did it start?
How did it all start, man? You know, it goes back to
being an identical twin.
Exactly, which I.
Yeah, being an identical twin, that's how it started. Because when you're an identical twin, when you're 1 year old, you're on the coach together and people are staring at you. Oh, look at that. Who's who? I wonder. Oh, they look so identical. Ooh. Then you get older. Oh, stand up. Go back to back. Oh, let me see your teeth. You know, so all your life as being an identical twin, people are always looking at you. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I actually started being an identical twin.
Okay. All right. So everything, I mean, I've seen twin. We've all seen twins before, and, you know, sometimes you feel things they feel and all these other things, right? Emotions, all kinds of things.
Well, my brother and I used to feel the same woman. I mean, no. Did I say that?
Yeah, you don't want to. Yeah,
that's
don't
a Ron Garrett line. Jeez.
You don't want to.
It is.
You don't want to do that on the Joey Chacone show. Yeah, because we it's all right.
Why not?
Yeah, because we want to stay nice and it's a family station.
This is a family station?
Yeah.
Oh, it's the family station? Don Corleone?
Yeah, all right. So let's get back to the twins. Your
hey, you
brother.
Know, there's the Nelson twins, Ricky Nelson's
very,
kids.
Exactly. Okay. Right.
There's a lot of twins that are entertainers. I met a couple of twins a couple of weeks ago in Los Angeles. They were just adorable.
Yeah, that was the Playboy twins that you were telling me about.
No. They were models. Actually, we were hosting a modeling show. My other half was the chef somewhere, and there was these two identical twins, and I said, I got to meet with you. They came to her restaurant, and we talked for 2 hours. So I'm always attracted to twins.
All right, so the bottom line is you're twins, you're performers, right? Is there's music in your family?
No, but there's not. My mother was, my mother loved to entertain people in an amateur-type way. My father, who never graduated fourth grade, was in awe with the accordion player and guitar player, so he wanted his kids to be entertainers. So I started playing guitar at 10 years old.
Oh, cool, man.
And by the time I was 12, I had a band.
Right.
And I used to be very shy and insecure because my father was very physical with me. So he wanted me to get up on stage at this Packer Park Swim Club, and I told him I couldn't do it. Okay. He says, I want you to sing. I said, I can't do it. So he takes me in the shower and beats the crap out of me until I go on stage and do it. He actually, it's in my book how he landed a couple of punches on me. But you know what? I think about it now. My father really didn't mean to hurt me. That was his way of giving me a love slap because he had big hands. He was a butcher.
My dad was a bricklayer, so yeah. I know those hands are big.
Big. So if he wanted to really hurt me. So my father encouraged my brother and I. He didn't want me to be a butcher. I didn't mind. I was sliced lunch meat and cut the leg of veal and stuff like that. But he wanted me to be an entertainer.
And how about your brother? Did he feel the same way with him?
We were twins. My parents let us do things together all the time. It was so annoying that we had to do things together all the time.
Okay, so if you did one thing, then he had to do something. If he did something, you had to do something.
They dressed us alike, got haircuts together.
Did that bother you? I mean,
yeah, I didn't like it at all. I regret the thought now, but I always tell people that when it was happening, I had no individuality. It was very difficult as a young...
I'm sure it would be because, you know, it's always about the twin, this, twins, that, blah, 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 blah. But
yeah, it was a... I was twinned out.
Right. But that being said, you performed, you picked up the guitar, you did get up on stage, obviously.
I did get on stage, yeah, I did. Started getting more confidence.
Right.
And at 12 years old, I'm on stage playing the guitar, and the girls would come on up and go, hi.
I know.
Ooh, this is nice.
Yeah.
Wow.
Can you sing this?
Wow.
Right?
So that really made it a little more convincing.
Right.
You would get the attention because I was so shy, I couldn't talk to women.
Right. So what a great ego, you know, ego confidence boost. I mean, it's very nice. But I want to stay with, we're young, we're performing. You started to perform all over, right? You're from Philly?
Yeah.
All right. Well, now I got to go for like a cheesesteak.
We
right
say
now.
South Philly, yeah, cheesesteak, yeah.
You still pissed off? Who cares? I don't care. All right, go ahead. No, I was talking to Ron over here.
I grew up in South Philly, and we started playing in birthday parties, sororities. We were making $15 for the trio, $5 a piece. I'm not making too much more now.
Not at all.
But
thank you. Thank you so much from the heart, okay? Because, you know, this is just the way it used to be. You know, how many times do I say it?
Yeah, so
it ain't that way anymore.
So then by the time I was 15 and 16, I was actually working the clubs. I had fake ID, and I was working bars.
But were you working with your brother at the time?
Yeah, it was called JT and the Twins. We had a guy named John Trollo. My brother played drums. I played guitar.
Right.
And I was working in a grocery store making $35 a week as a stock boy.
Okay.
And I was making $125 a weekend performing right. as an entertainer.
Right, and having girls, you know, doing the whole, you know.
Fake ID, drinking.
Fake ID. Oh, what more do you God. Want? Felt like a king.
So that was till I was 18 years old, and I worked the school dances, and then I went into the Marine Corps.
Okay. See, I just want to say, with Tony, I like to always, you know, we want to get inside him, see what he's really about, and that's what I love, man. It's like the honesty. But, you know, I just want to back up a minute because I don't want to rush ahead, but someone helped you guys basically when you were younger that got you to Las Vegas. Is that correct? And you've been been here since 81?
No. Younger. We're still 15 years old
can
now.
Can we go back? Because I'm talking to, you know who I'm talking
you're
about.
So. I know, but you're bringing me up 15 years. Wait a minute. I get that.
God, yeah. You know what? I think it's a good time for a break. What do you
Hello,
think?
Hello. I'm on a radio interview. Who's on the phone?
We'll be right back. Thanks a lot. Joey Ciccone back with you. The way it used to be. Tony Sacca taking calls in the middle of the show. I mean,
hey, you know what? Could have been a booking agent.
No donut. I don't care. It could wait. The clock went off. It was crazy in here, all right? People started dancing. I don't know. It was wild. So, go ahead.
We want a commercial break. Okay, you had me at 15.
Okay, so.
Then, Aspeth,
1 minute, please. With all respect. So I was moving. Tony was. All right, I'll tell you right now.
Shut cell phones.
Yeah, I'll be real nice because for all my friends out there listening, you know how I get sometimes. Shut the phone off. It's that simple. Or I sit here and I'll sing for 2 hours. I don't care.
Shut the phone off.
All right, anyway, phones are going off, people contacting people.
Okay, well, we were at I went into the Marine Corps at 18.
Okay, good.
Got out of the Marine Corps. And I was putting my band back together with my twin brother.
Okay, very good.
Okay. So we're 18, 19, 20, 21. We're working all the top joints in Jersey, down the shore, Wildwood, Atlantic City. I worked the 500 Club the year it burned down. And at 21 years old, I started headlining at the Surf Club in Wildwood, New Jersey, my first headlining appearance with my twin brother.
And you guys had a 7-8-piece band. I saw a picture. That's all I saw.
We had a gigantic. We had 4 dancing girls, 2 saxes, 4 rhythm. It was 10 or 12 called Bandstand 72, and then at 73 we became the Sacca Twins Review, and we started touring all around the country. We started working the Sheridans and the Ramadas and the Hiltons. So I did that, and then after traveling for 3 or 4 years, my brother and I took off, got a job in Philly, and started going to New York as an actor and took acting lessons for about a year and a half. I went to New York, and I landed a Fresca Soda commercial. I landed a Juicy Fruit chewing gum commercial. My brother and I were asked to do Doublemint chewing gum, but we were on the road at the time.
But by the way, you got any gum right now?
No.
Oh, yeah? Okay, go ahead.
No. So we're traveling, then I took off for 2 years to study in New York as an actor, but I was working at the Hilton, and yeah, I used to do Elvis when I was younger. I did an Elvis personation, the jumpsuit and everything like that, and Elvis was going to stay at the Hilton, and they were going to introduce me to Elvis because they loved the way I used to do Elvis. I don't know if I ever told you this, Ron. Elvis was supposed to watch me do him. And at that week, Elvis, the hotel went on strike, so Elvis would not cross the picket line, but I was still playing there, so... And then I went back on the road in 77, 78, was asked to perform in Puerto Rico in 79 for 4 weeks, and it lasted 3 years, 79, 80, and 81.
With your brother, what was it, San Juan, what is
San
it called?
San Juan, Puerto Rico at the El San Juan Hotel.
Yeah, that's the one I'm talking
And that's where Siegfried
Thank you. Okay.
came yeah. to see, he visited Puerto Rico because they had the MGM Grand Fire. He was out of work. A lot of the dancers were at Hollywood, Hello, Hallelujah Hollywood, were working in the big showroom at the El San Juan Hotel. So Siegfried came down to see them, and everybody kept saying, you got to see the Sacca Twins. So Siegfried came to see the Sacca Twins, and he was so in awe of our act. He said, you got to come to Vegas. You're a great Vegas act.
All right, let me ask you something. What style were you doing? What style? Was it the style that was popular at the time, or what? What style of music were you guys doing?
We did... We always did doo-wop in our act.
Okay.
I always did it.
So you like doo-wop a lot, right?
Well, I grew up in Philly.
Yeah, sit around a garbage can, you know.
We did doo-wop. I did Elvis. I always did a 15-minute Elvis skit. Okay, there's a picture of me with glasses and a wig, and I used to do this. And my brother was, we used to do the oldie thing. People didn't even know it was us. And then we did a Barry Manilow medley. And then we did, of course, we did all disco, Staying Alive, How Deep Is Your Love. We did The Tramps. So we did a variety of
okay,
music.
Okay, so you were doing what was going on then, and you were traveling. All your guys, too, to keep a band together. Obviously, folks, people are getting paid. Okay?
Right.
I just wanted to put that out there. All right, so the bottom line is now you got a band. Are they under a contract at the time, if I can ask?
No, I'm under the contract, and the musicians are under me.
Right, so, you want to get a check, you want to play, of course they want to, you're traveling,
yeah,
right?
I was very successful as an entertainer. I always worked, I had a great career before I came to Vegas, so I didn't come to Vegas to try to make it. I already had a wonderful career. I worked at the Fontainebleau, the Marco Polo.
You worked the one in Miami, right?
Yeah.
I love that place.
Yeah, so my fantastic brother and I, we were lucky. We worked everywhere around the country, never out of work. And so I was very fulfilled as an entertainer before I got here. And then
you got here then what, 1981, mm-hmm. may we say? Because now we're, is this a 50-year journey from starting, from the beginning of your life, right? You're not 100 years old.
The 50-year journey is when this book was written. It was 50 years. 50 years. I was 12, so they started writing this book 52, 53, I think.
Right.
No. Wait a minute. I'm 64.
Well, yeah, say your age. 64. Had a lot of work done, basically, and that's how you look at that at 64. Gabish?
All right. I had a lot of work. I drink Kangen water.
Well, I had to get back for the phone going off, all right? What do you do for a hobby?
What do I do for a hobby?
Yeah. People want to know this stuff.
Ron Garrett comes to my house and talks to me for half hour.
Oh, he's a chacarón. I sat with, by the way, thank you for having me at Carmine's.
Yes.
New York City at Caesars.
Yeah, Carmine's. Yeah, that was a fabulous
and that's
restaurant.
And I want you to say it again because me and Ron were talking.
Yeah.
What is the truth? What's the thing about the truth in Italian? What is it? The vino? What is it?
In vino.
I like to break them on you now,
veritas.
Right? You like it, huh? I'll say it
vino
again.
Veritas.
Say it again.
Dinner conversation with Tony, Ron, and Rich. And
your guest was?
Who was our guest last week? I don't remember. Joey, baby. Joey.
Tony signed the book. Tony signed the book for me. I got the clock signed. It's respect. These are Italians. These are the type of people we are. We give. I know right now you're foaming. Right now over here, you can't wait. One of my sponsors, Pink Box. You got to love them, all right? Oh, he's got the beautiful book. We're going to talk about the clock. And then let's hear this a minute now. Perfect for Christmas.
My Las Vegas Rocks clock, Vegas Vinny. I got the pig. Go to my website, TonySaka.com. You could buy these. My clock, my book.
Beautiful, man. Yeah. And you know, it's a catchy tune.
It is.
You wrote the tune.
I wrote it.
Were you thinking of maybe like Elvis a little bit when you kind of wrote it? Just not that I'm saying you ripped things off. I'm just saying that was it in a type of vibe, you know, like, you know.
No, you know, I don't think I was thinking Elvis at the time when I wrote that.
When'd you write it?
I wrote this song when I was celebrating my 20th year on television.
Very nice.
This is 30 years. Please. I wrote it 10 years ago. Wow.
Okay.
I wrote The Greatest Town Around in 1981 when I moved to Las Vegas, which I sang on the David Letterman show in 86, and they put this in the time capsule, the Downtown Transportation Center, they're going to open up the capsule in 2086. So when I'm there,
2086.
When I'm there, I'm going to tell them it's my song.
Right, because you're going to be there, because you do that, fibrogenics or whatever, you go in a room where they freeze you. What is it called?
Cryogenics.
Yeah, you're all scientists, all right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's why you're going to be there.
I'll be there. What?
You've
got to throw me out first. So I wrote The Greatest Town Around. I wrote A Rainy Day in Vegas. I wrote Vegas Nights. I wrote Las Vegas Rocks, Jump Jive in Las Vegas. So I got seven Vegas songs that I wrote.
All right. tell us something in your life that people don't know. You know, it'd be nice. Obviously, you were, you know, today's a special day for me because, as you know, we're Italians. I lost my dad in 2001, who was my backbone that kept me in Hollywood for 25 years and always pushing. So it's a sentimental day, but, you know, something people didn't know, you know, what you had to go through when you were young. You know, and I'm sorry, but Tony, it's an important thing, you know.
When I was younger?
Yeah, I'm saying, you know, being cracked around.
No, because
now if you do it.
Yeah, my father beat me up. And again, I think about it. I hated him until I was like 18, 19. Then I realized he really didn't want to hurt me.
Right.
That's the only way he knew how to discipline me.
Now, out of respect, may I speak of your brother? And his name was?
Robert.
And he passed.
Leukemia.
Correctly. Okay, so, you know, may it rest in peace. But, you know, these are... I got a friend that's dealing with cancer. I got a friend that's another one that's dealing with a form of leukemia, and you know, these are things that you know we got to be able to.
Well, you know, the lesson here, and I talk about it in my book, is my brother. I exercise and diet. He was bulimic, so I think he got leukemia because he really destroyed his body, his immune system. I think I believe that.
Okay.
And I've been preaching diet and health for many, 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 many years.
It has to be. It's a must.
I also, for the last 15 years, and this year I haven't done it, but I fasted 10 to 15 days every 6 months where you don't eat.
It's good to fast and clean your body up, clean your soul out and everything. But the other night you were eating the bread like it was nothing.
No, I wasn't eating bread the other night. I did not have no bread.
Was that Ron?
I was saying I'm gluten-free tonight.
I know. These are jokes and ball break. They're free. You don't have to pay for them. They're free.
Who would pay for those?
Nice. It's all right. We know how we do things, right, Helen?
So,
right. Let's get back to...
So, Robert decided to
Goulet?
Go the other way. Robert Sackett tried to go the other
right.
way.
Right. Not me. Seriously, and, please.
And, it, you know, we had a great career up to... up to about 40 years old, him and I were like very close, and then we started going our separate ways. I figured we didn't make it as an act like the Nelson twins or the Hudson brothers or the Smothers brothers, so it's time to go on my own, which I've always wanted to have my own identity.
Would you have liked that, like if you made it like as twins and, you know,
I would have liked it. My brother wasn't
so
destructive. I would have loved it. I was proud to be a Sackett twin. I mean, we were known as the Sackett twins all over the East Coast.
Right.
They didn't know my name, and I was proud to be a Sackett twin. I would say I'm a Sackett twin. You know?
Did the Sackett twins perform here in Vegas?
Yes. We came here. We got 4 weeks at the MGM Grand, and they booked us for 3 years right off the bat.
Okay, so, Tony, let's put the cards on the table. I got to ask you, at that time, I'm just saying, was it for Siegfried?
No.
Did you the favor to plug you in?
No.
He asked you to come to Vegas.
Yeah, because he wanted Robert and I don't know, a lot of magicians use identical twins.
Okay.
See, they don't really put Mumbai in the box and they pop out. They're twins. So that's the secret with magicians. They were thinking about using my brother and I as twins in a box.
Oh, man. So, like, these magicians that come on and stuff, we just gave, like, a little secret away.
Yeah.
Of what they do.
Yeah,
so.
They use identical twins. And one magician, I don't remember the guy from the Flamingo, used triplets. They were redheads. He was a magician, triplets. That was real good. So, but I was working with in New York City, Hermes Russell, who had a friend who's Art Angler, who was a booking agent here. He's the one that had me audition for Bernie Rothkopf, and he loved us. So we got a job right away at the MGM Grand because they went on strike.
Right.
And all the musicians left, so they said, would you like to work? I said, okay. So we got it there. We stood 4 weeks, and we stayed 3 years at the MGM Grand.
Okay, so your brother was with you for how long here in Vegas performing
We broke Vegas 81. We probably stopped working together in 95. We started the TV show together, so we stopped working about 95. I went on my own in 95.
Right.
Yeah.
Well... And we're going to pick up from there when we come back.
Where are we going?
With Tony. Well, right now, Tony's going to receive a beautiful presidential award.
No, he did already.
Well, he's going to. Either people are going to see it that you're receiving it. We know you received it already.
Oh, you did?
But they're going to see it like you're getting it now. Okay?
Why are they going to see me getting it now?
Yeah, because I'm going to give it to you now when we go to commercial. Joey Ciccone, the way it used to be. I'll be right back.
He helps the community. Thank you for being here. If we go. And this lady says, I want to submit you for an award. And I totally forgot about it. About 5 weeks ago, I was a judge for the Miss America pageant with Miss Debbie Boone. And this lady says to me, by the way, you got the award. I go, for what? She goes, oh, the White House. I go, what White House? So she's presenting me this award from the White House for my accomplishments, signed by Barack Obama. So let me bring her up right now and introduce this lady who actually submits these things to the White House to be recognized for a lot of community service, a lot of hours. And this is Susan Jeske. And she, you tell me what happened. Go ahead.
Okay, well, this award is the Presidential Award, and it actually started in 2003 by President George W. Bush, and it's the Presidential Award, and it's for people who do volunteer service. And when I first met you, it was at an event that you were volunteering at, and just, it was really amazing to watch you, and I started researching who you were and who you are, because I come to Vegas a lot, and it's just really impressive all the things that you've done for the community and for all, for individuals. It's just really, really amazing. So I became the certifier for the President of the United States in 2004, and so I submitted you for the award. I didn't have enough information, so it did take a while to get it completely certified. And then you were certified, and I got it. And so on behalf of the President of the United States, the White House, and the Points of Light Foundation, I would like to present to you the Lifetime Achievement Award for your volunteer service and all of your the community events that you've done throughout the Las Vegas. You do get is you get the certificate, which is signed by the President of the United States. You do get a medal, so I'd like to present you with the medal. And he also receives a lapel pin.
Oh, I guess we'll put it on, huh?
I think you should put it on. It's actually very cool.
Ladies and gentlemen, Susan Jeske, thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. I see trees of green.
Everybody, Joey Ciccone back Ciccone. In the house.
Joey Ciccone. Oh, man, I can go for one of those donuts.
I got Mr. Saka with me. What was that?
I want one of those donuts.
One of the pink box donuts?
Oh, God, I can't wait to eat a donut.
Oh, no, you got a hat. Let me just show you.
Let me see.
You got to see what's going on. Pink box, one of my sponsors. Beautiful. Roberto, we love you.
Oh, my God.
Let me just show you what's going on.
Look at these donuts.
Look. Are these beautiful or what? Huh?
Oh, they smell so good.
They're delicious. And when you go in there over there in Summerlin, you'll have one later. Don't worry about
it. Pink box.
Pink box.
Pink box.
Yeah, the box is pink. And when you go in there, Joey Ciccone sent me in. You get the free cup of coffee. It's beautiful. Check it out. It's in Summerlin. I got the address here. I'm going to lay on you before the second show ends. Also, our nice medical people we're going to be talking about that are supporting us right now. You know, we're going to be talking about that. Let's get back into where we were over here, okay? We just saw now a nice piece that was where?
That was at Ron DeCar's Event Center when I celebrated my 30th year in show business, my placing of the star at the Paris Hotel and the award from the White House from Barack Obama.
Okay, but obviously...
That's all.
Yeah, Tony, just a few things, you know.
We get the letter from Harry Reid. That was nice.
We hope you don't float out of here, you know, just a few things.
No, Ron Garrett said, I get so many awards, people could think he died. Tony Saka die?
We're going to give you an award today, too.
Yeah, he did, because I did the show 2 weeks ago. I wasn't there. They called me the late Tony Saka. I'm reading this. I go, did I die? I didn't even know I died.
So you got the stars. Where now on the Paris?
My star is right at the Paris Hotel. It is an incredible spot, right on the corner, right next to Engelbert Humperdinck and Elvis Presley and who? Me.
See, folks, you don't have to interview Tony. He interviews himself. All right, it's a beautiful thing. But
I learned that at a young age, how to do it myself.
We got that. What do we call this, the fur animal?
This is Vegas Vinny.
Yeah, a minute?
A minute for
how
what?
How did that happen? Because of the thing? We just came back. Mano.
We don't have to go anywhere.
We got a minute. That's all right. Don't worry about it.
Oh, for the sponsors? What are we doing?
We're doing you and...
Cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha. Oh, that's...
What it goes way back. You're in a white suit. She's in a pink outfit.
Charo, we were downtown Fremont Street when we were closing our PBS special. Are we on?
Yeah, well, he's going to go to it, but she's coming.
On?
Yeah.
Now, let me tell you, when I was asked to do a PBS special, they asked me to ask Nancy Sinatra and Margaret.
That would be great, yeah. Of course.
Sheena Easton.
Of course.
Or Charo.
Okay.
So when I recommended Charo, because I don't have anything in common with Nancy Sinatra. I don't have anything in common with Anne Margaret. Or Sheena, I asked Sheena.
No, they're just gorgeous, beautiful women, but you have nothing in common with
them. I did ask Sheena Easton if she wanted to do this PBS special with me. And I thought the company was paying pretty good.
All right, let's pick it up. Let them see it. You know, it'd be nice if they saw it, and then we'll come back to it. You could explain a little bit of it.
Okay, go ahead.
Is that all right?
Roll that video.
This is magnificent. You know, Charo, I couldn't think of a better place to end the show than where it all began, right here in Las Vegas on Fremont Street. Now the Fremont Street Experience under the canopy of lights is wonderful.
This is surreal. I just love it.
Loved working with you. You
Tony, I had such a wonderful time working with you, but it's something is happening.
What?
Oh, I'm Jew now. I became Italian. What's the matter with me, Tony? Can you stop that?
You know, same thing is happening to me now. Ever since we've been working together, I started wanting to coochie-coochie, and I started doing all this stuff, and I want to say, I'm having a lot of fun, and we thank you for watching the show, everyone.
Mamma mia, I'm Italian now.
This is Entertainment Las Vegas style, and bye-bye, my friend Jacko.
What's the matter with me,
back with Mr. Saka, please, Tony.
That was
go right back into it.
Charo, yeah. So I knew Charo. She's done a couple of my TV shows, and I said, Charo, would you like to do a PBS special with me? She goes, okay. I said, this is what they're paying. She goes, okay. So
real sweet lady.
Real sweet. So we got Ed Swindle's Rolls Royce. So we figured we'd drive us around in the Rolls Royce and go all these different locations. I thought it'd be a classy move. So we get in the Rolls Royce. Charo goes, what are we doing? She goes, no Rolls Royce. Josette, my other half.
Yes, Josette.
I
want to say hello to you.
Hi, Josette. Had a Hummer. So Charo goes,
the vehicle.
It was a Hummer. So we drove in the Hummer. I drove, and her husband, Shelt, sat next to me, and Charo and Josette were in the back seat. We drove around all the locations. It's an incredible show. And I'll tell you how classy of a woman is. I said this the other day at my party. You weren't invited.
Yeah, well, I'm not invited to any of the things except for
we weren't friends at that time.
No, but I've known you for about 11 years. But anyway, go ahead.
So I said, we're ready to do the gondola scene. And she goes, where can I go change? So I went up to the PR girl. I says, Chara would like to change. Where could she change? She goes, tell her to go into the ladies' room.
My own, right?
So I said, Charlie, they want you to change in the ladies' room. She says, I change worse.
So, you know, real super humble, sweet lady, sounds like. I met her one time in Beverly Hills one time, but that was a great guitarist also.
I got her playing in front of the Bellagio flamenco guitar.
It's
brilliant.
She rips it up. If you ever want to see Charo play the guitar, just YouTube it. It's incredible, man.
Yeah.
She's all over the place.
So she wound up doing this PBS special with me, and you just saw that clip. That was the ending of it.
Right.
I can't remember why we did that. We had something else written, and I can't remember why we changed it, but that was a total ad lib, and she loved it, and I loved it.
Let me ask you something.
Ask me something.
What's the weirdest thing a fan has ever done for you?
Has done to me?
Well, done for you. We don't need to get into to you. For you. Make sure you take care of all this, okay? John? All right. for my friends out in Radio Land. We're just, you know, we're having fun. It's Friday. We're goofing.
You know,
around the
when
studio.
I was younger, you know, all these girls wanted to cook for me, and all my fans, and I'll never forget this. We were like 21 years old in South Philly, 22, and these girls invited us over to the house for dinner, and they made this big dinner, and we never showed up. And she drove down from the Northeast, knocked on my door in South Philly, and threw the food at me. I'll never forget that one.
So that would fall into one of the
that
nice
was a
things
fan,
a fan did
you
for
said,
you.
Did to me.
Yeah, but you know what?
That was one of the things for me. I mean, the people who really like what you do, they'll take you out to dinner all the time, and
right,
they'll buy you things, and
buy
stuff
you a
like
drink,
that. You know,
invite you to Carmine's New York City Caesars, beautiful time.
Yeah.
His show. What's the name of the show?
In Vino Veritas.
Touche. I love that. You want to break them on me?
11.
Joey Ciccone, we'll be right back. Here's a tune I did as a kid called Home on Christmas Day.
I like that.
Little Christmas thing I did with the bells. It was nice. It was beautiful. It's because the holidays are here, Tone. You know what I'm saying?
You know, I could take this, and Mike Weatherford said this last year, that Tony Sacca is a tradition when it comes to Christmas, because I started producing the first Christmas show 29 years ago. They weren't celebrating Christmas, so I started doing Christmas shows because the town was dead. Nobody was doing anything. So I started doing Christmas shows. I've done 29 Christmas shows. I've done 10 at the Stratosphere. I've done 6 at Mount Charleston. I've done 1 at the Riviera. I've done 1 at the Santa Fe. I've done 2 at Boulder Station. So I've produced 29 Christmas shows featuring everyone from Charo to Cookie Jar to a lot of celebrities.
So could you be like considered like, you know, Mr. Christmas?
Well, Mike Weatherford said Tony Sacca is a tradition when it comes to Christmas in this town.
Well, I think it shows right here with the lovely gifts that you brought and sharing all this these little things with us, which we'd like to cover more deeper, you know, in the next half in my other show, which is The Way It Is.
Oh, do you have 2 shows?
Yeah, we do 2 hours, and you have.
No, is it 2 different shows?
Yeah, and you happen to be the guest on the second show.
Oh, I'm the guest.
Yeah, you should ask your agent. Maybe he'll give you like the info on what's going on. But Tone, we love you being here.
Thank you.
East Coast guy. A lot of respect. Joey Ciccone signing off right now. We're going to be back in about 5 minutes, all right? Tony Sacca in the house. Las Vegas ambassador of entertainment. Check
I'll
tell
it out. You how I got that touch.
Here's Joey Ciccone.
Hey, gang, how you doing? Happy Friday. It's the holiday season. We are back here at 5 o'clock Pacific Coast time. I hope you're listening to me out there, all my friends on Facebook, and all over the United States, family in Chicago and everything. Dad, happy birthday. God bless you. Keep watching over us. I wanted to mention some things that I did in the first show, but I want to just clarify some stuff that's very important to me, which is our new sponsors, okay? All right? And I wanted to get this very clear. So, Roberto, thank you. It's Pink Box Donuts. If you go in there, okay, and you tell them Joey Ciccone sent me in here, okay? I was listening to his show. You're going to get a free coffee, all right? Say, Joey sent me. Give me the free coffee, all right? Pink Box, classic and gourmet donuts. Open 24 hours in Summerlin. That's at Summer Hill Plaza, 7531 West Summerlin, Lake Mead, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89128. The other location's in Henderson. It is not 24 hours. 10251 Southeastern Avenue, Henderson, Nevada, 89147. Now, if they go in there during normal, regular hours, they can still get the coffee.
Right, with the purchase of a donut.
Right, I'm talking about in Henderson.
Correct, yes.
All right, so two Pink Box locations, check them out. It's the bomb, man. I have one maybe once a week after a heavy, heavy workout all week long. Our other sponsors, I said this incorrectly earlier, had a little frog in my throat, been having a sore throat lately. That's been bothering me. But Innovative Care Physician Group, there it is. Okay, Dr. Goldsmith, as owner and CEO of Time Care, or Trim Care, I apologize, has developed a revolutionary program that utilizes a combination of medication, supplements, diet, and behavior modification to create patient-specific. I don't want to go through the whole thing, but I want to say that Reva there works with the your skin, Botox, fillers. I'm going to get more into that. They're going to have their own commercial in their own spot, but I do want to pay respect for them being a sponsor of the Joey Ciccone Show the way it used to be and the way it is. Okay, so you got that happening. Now, moving right along, I met these people kind of on a freak trip in the airport, and these people are Joey and Rory. If you know them, they're the country vocal duo, okay? And met them just passing, and we were talking, and actually I had a layover, and I was in a bar, and they were there, and I just knew them as Joey and Rory. My prayers go out to her. Last night at 8 p.m. Central Time, they had a prayer that is called Joey's Prayer. Friends, basically, she's a beautiful, beautiful country star, and she's dying of cancer, and it's very sad. And the prayer said, for a miracle, and even more so, for peace with his decision. And everybody kind of said that at a certain time last night, and we hope it brings, maybe a miracle. And I met the people shortly. I didn't really know them, but I did want to say something about them on the show. Okay, so sad things, you know what I'm saying? But that's life, and we got to deal with it sometime. I mean, it's good and bad, but losing someone is very, very, very painful. I was talking about people's attitudes and everything, okay? People are tripping out there a little bit, you know what I'm saying? All right? I mean, it's different now. It's like, can't you just be nice? Someone call me and be nice. It'd be nice, you know what I'm saying? Tony Sanka is my guest today. He was on the first show here. It's Tony Sanka, the Las Vegas Ambassador of Entertainment. Guy's been around a long time. This is a 50-year journey, talking about himself and his twin brother that had started in the entertainment business. And if you know, Tony's has radio shows and TV shows, and so he's going to be coming back. We're going to be talking to him a little bit more and getting in some more in-depth questions, stuff that, like, I like to ask stuff like the normal person doesn't ask. You know what I'm saying? Like that, like the question about, what's your hobby? People want to know certain things about people. When I get interviewed, they ask me like stuff like that. When you get to the gates of heaven, what will you say? What will you say? I don't know what I'll say, but I don't plan on going there very soon. Let's just keep it that way. All right. But Pink Box, we love you. Okay, and. Am I saying it right? Innovative. I'm saying it right. Innovative Care. Yeah, right. That's right. Physician Group. Right. That's really the over right. name of our sponsors. So very well. Thanksgiving coming, obviously. Christmas right around the corner. Do accept gifts. Can they send it to the station here? Okay. Yeah. Because I don't want them to have my address. So if you'd like to send something, just do me a favor. Don't send like a fish. A fish head. That's a problem. You know what I'm saying? Do you know what that means, Helen, when they send that to you?
It's not good news.
You're going to be sleeping with the fishes, right? And we kind of, some of our guests have, have they not done that? Because we love the mob hour. Even Lawrence, the engineer, he likes the mob days. Joe, who is it? Oh, my God. I better not say anything. All right, we've had some great times, but like I said, we have Tony. We're going to be doing a show coming up in Florida and Chicago coming up soon. I have Miss Helen Carr here. She manages me, okay? And that's joeyciccone.com, okay, is my website. And then our company, because She is a business partner, is called the Green Cat Ventures. And lay that number on them just from there, the Green Cat Ventures numbers. The 1-800 number is, let's see if she remembers.
1-800-925.
Oh, and Lawrence brought the room up for you. So you got a live mic.
0390, extension 011.
Right, say it again. The Green Cat Ventures, that's our company, okay? Mm-hmm. And we want you to call because entertainment is
right,
our thing.
For the holidays, in case you need somebody to sing Christmas songs or
yeah, I'm just gonna I'm just going to stand on a corner and sing Christmas songs with a guitar case open.
Like
this is my manager booking. This is great, isn't it? All right, yeah. Yeah, I go from $5 I go from $5,000 a night. Now I'm just singing like, how about if I knock on their door and I'm like, yeah, thanks for the bells. Give me a hi. Deck the halls with bells of holly. Fala. Thank you. Boom. They shut the door. You know, throw money, okay? Whatever you want to do, all right? Anyway, bringing Tony back and real nice broadcaster that I've just met recently. And I was just giving him a hard time earlier, but obviously they didn't catch the humor. But Ron Garrett, very, very sweet man. And he's booked some very, very big acts, and he's done some fantastic broadcasting things. Right now we're going to clip Tony, a celebration of a song, a celebration of songs.
Ladies and gentlemen, back for an encore presentation at the Smith Center for the Performing Arts. It's a celebration of song with entertainment ambassador Tony Sacca.
Listen. Do you want to know a secret? Do you promise not to tell? Whoa, 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 closer. Oh, 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 we could be on a desert, lost without a place to go. And we're so in love with each other that you wouldn't even know. Around the world, are you ready for a brand new beat? Summer's here, time is right. Dancing in the streets, dancing in Chicago,
dancing in the streets.
I'm down in New Orleans,
dancing in the streets,
and in New York City,
dancing in the streets.
Way down Louisiana, across to New Orleans. Way back up in the woods among the evergreens. A good and old cabin made of earth and wood. A munchy boy named Johnny B. Good. Never, never learned to read or write as well. Playing guitar just like a ringing a bell. Go, go. Well, singing a baby now.
Singing a baby.
Twist and shout.
Twist and shout.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, baby now. Has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see. You've lost that love and feeling. Oh, that love and feeling. You lost that love and feeling. Now it's gone. Let me love you, baby. Let me.
me love you. I need to know that you will always be the same old someone that I knew. Ah, oh, what will it take till you believe in me the way that I believe in you? I say that's life. And as funny as it may seem, some people get their kicks stomping on a dream. I don't let it get me down, 'cause this final world, it keeps spinning around. America, sweet America, God shed his grace on me and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea.
Everybody, Joey Ciccone back with you. The Way It is what it's called. The Way It Is, baby. We got clocks. We got furry animals. We got books, CDs. We got Mr. Saki here, all right? Fellow Italian, man. Italian-American-Italian. Italian-American.
Yeah, well, you know, we got Italian-Italian, right? My grandfather. Then my father was Italian-American. And then when I was born, I'm an American-Italian.
So all right, so what are we, like Sicilian, Napolitan, what?
Well, I'm all Sicilian, both sides of my family.
Yeah, they kill people all day long. That's all they do.
It's my mentality.
At least I sing the song, and then I kill them. The Napolitan.
By the way, the clip was from the Smith Center last
year. I was going to just say that, but go ahead. You're a host, so go. You say it.
That's from the Smith Center. And I was very honored to perform at the Smith Center. It's not an easy endeavor.
February and July of last year.
Last year, it was February and July.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
And to work the Smith Center is an honor. They do it first rate. But you really got to get it together. You know, you got a lot of expenses to work the Smith Center.
Sure.
You got to bring people in.
You had a big band.
I had a big band, too. So I brought some sponsors with me. So it turned out to be real good because I made that great demo reel with my production company that I own.
And what's the name of that production?
Saka Productions. It's different.
Very
Saka
nice. Productions.
You know, I bought some land. When I was a kid, people used to call me Saka Potatoes, so I opened up a company called Saka Potatoes, and I was buying some raw land. So the title company said, what is Saka Potatoes? It's the name of my company.
Yeah, you can name it anything. It don't matter, right?
Yeah, but by the way, you showed something when I received that award from Barack Obama, the White House. About 2 years ago, I was in California drinking some wine, and this lady came up to me. She says, you know, Tony,
we love wine.
I think I'm going to submit you to the White House to get an award. Now, we're drinking, so after we left that day, I thought that was cocktail conversation. Never thought anything about it until 6-7 weeks ago, and she called me up and said, I did get the award. I said, for what? She goes, from the White House. I said, what are you talking about? So she showed me that she submitted my credentials to the White House. You know, everything I've done over the last 40 years. We went to the White House 4 times. I raised money to bring 18 kids to the White House to sing at the White House 4 times.
Oh, that's great.
And with my Christmas show. My Christmas show, we would raise money to bring kids or help them or buy them wardrobes and stuff like that. Right. So I had a youth foundation for almost 30 years.
So is that still going on or is that stopped?
I still have a youth foundation, but I got to tell you, this year I slowed down a little bit because I've done a lot of stuff and done a lot of benefits and stuff like that. But now that I'm getting into that senior age.
Yeah, will there be a Christmas show this year?
I don't think I'm going to do a Christmas show. I think what I'm going to do is starting after Thanksgiving, I'm going to run 6 Christmas shows.
Very nice.
Because I have Christmas shows of 29 years and I got all these stars.
Right.
So I'm going to run my previous Christmas shows. They're all good. because, you know, Santa Claus is coming to town, never goes out of it.
Right. So, Tone, tell us about the stations and when we could sit down. We're sitting there at the TV and we're watching.
Actually, I created a new show called Classic Vegas Entertainment. It's a compilation of my 30 years of interviewing celebrities like Anthony Quinn and Milton Berle and Temptations, the Four Tops.
Which are cats you came across in your lifetime. I've seen the pictures and everything.
I actually had opportunity.
I didn't get to read the book, but now I got the book. I could read it. You know, you should read the book before the interview. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But it's beautiful, man. I really appreciate you signing it. But it's got some beautiful pictures in here.
I got Tommy DeVito. Every time I go to San Gennaro, he comes up and goes, I love watching you sing, Tony.
Right.
Compliment from Tommy DeVito.
And you got Milton here, right?
Milton
Milty, Uncle Milty. And who else is in here?
Oh, we got Tony Curtis.
Right.
We got Vanna White. We got Regis Philbin. We got Lou Rawls, Louis Anderson, Connie Francis, David Brenner, Suzanne Summers, Roseanne Arnold, Roseanne Barr, Jerry Van Dyke, Charo, Sherman Hemsley,
yeah,
Temptations, Red Fox, Rita Rudner.
Yeah, and they're all alive. They're all alive.
It's incredible.
It's got some incredible stuff. All right, let me ask you some stuff here.
Ask me anything you want.
I'm trying to, but you know, you're used to being a host and stuff, so it's kind of hard,
both.
You know. Yeah, well, you could answer your own questions.
I could do a green screen and go from side to side.
It's great when you can answer your own questions, right?
You know why? There's one thing I learned about interviewing. Do not ask the question if you don't know the answer.
Right. Well, that's why you do your research, what I call is doing your research, doing your homework, basically. You want to know what you're talking about, you know what I'm saying? And if the guy, if you pull it off real nice and fake it, maybe the guy doesn't know anything.
Oh, there's
you know
some people who've interviewed me over the past and did not know that I was an identical twin.
Yeah, we just heard something from someone that was on a show. I'm not going to name names. He said he's been interviewed with some pretty bizarre people that are not asking questions. On that note, what's your biggest fear?
What's my biggest fear? I don't think I have any fears.
You're a healthy guy.
Yeah, but I really don't fear anything.
But you're a healthy guy.
I'm a very healthy guy. I think if you believe in God, I don't think you have to fear anything.
All right, that's a beautiful answer. Leave that one alone there. Single, married, you know, people want to know out there. There's a lot of girls right now. These pinup models that were here, they want to know. They were asking me.
Let's say I'm committed.
Yes, and I happen to know the lovely lady.
She's
French.
Yes. I've really enjoyed being with her 10 years. You know, she's my number four, and I was talking to a priest in Beverly Hills 2 weeks ago, and I said, Father, the Catholic Church excommunicates people for getting divorces. He says, well, we're trying to change that. I said, you know, Father, I think the Bible, when it said, till death do you part, I don't really think the Bible actually meant you had to physically die. I think the Bible meant if your love dies for one another, then you could separate. So he thought about that, the priest. Why would God want you to be miserable until you die? I think if the love dies between two people,
it's over.
It's over.
Well,
so I think that's what the Bible. The Bible didn't say to you physically die.
Right.
It says till death do you part.
Right, but the bottom line is that's why they came up with something called divorce, folks, okay? Or don't get married. It's that simple.
Well, marriage is a wonderful thing, really. I love marriage. I love commitment.
How do you feel that your did the nationality, you know, your nationality play a part in any success in your career?
I think, you know, being Italian is not easy when you're trying to climb up the ladder unless you know somebody.
I'll have to agree with you. Where a lot of cats, a lot of big names change their names.
Having a vowel at the end of your name is not always a positive thing, which I've learned. I'm proud to be an Italian. I love my heritage. I love the way I grew up with the family values and the food and friendship and neighbors.
That's very important.
So that's the way I live. And getting to know other ethnic backgrounds, they live differently in life. So I'm proud to be an Italian.
Right,
it's not
beautiful.
Easy.
How about, like, what pisses you off? What, you know, you got, like, a pet peeve? I have a lot of things, but which one of yours? See, there's questions that are different.
You know, I never even thought about what pissed me off.
No, we could come back after the segment and figure that out. Something might piss you off in the next half hour.
I guess people ask me that question. What pisses you off pisses me off, I guess.
what pisses you off doesn't really piss me off. So what pisses me off is what do we got going on? We got 1 minute. All right, listen. Who's your favorite entertainer?
Favorite entertainer. I can't say I have one favorite entertainer.
All right, then I'll give you, you can have three.
Influences. I think Barry Manilow was an influence to me as a songwriter and a singer.
Yeah,
Lou
great
Rawls,
stuff.
Friend of mine, great singer. Bobby Darin, great singer.
Loved him.
Louis Prima, great singer.
Right.
Frankie Valli, great singer. I appreciate all those people who have influenced my life as an entertainer.
You like them all. That's very nice. Okay. And how about your actor, real quick, and then we'll go to the song. Yeah, favorite actor.
I like Matthew McConaughey. I think
McConaughey.
McConaughey.
Yeah, that's right.
McConaughey. Matthew McConaughey.
He's good. He does the Cadillac commercials. They're fun, right?
No, it's Lincoln.
Oh, that's right. It's Lincoln. Oh, I got a Cadillac.
I like Matthew. I do like I like Bruce Willis.
Yeah?
Nice.
East Coast guys.
Nice, right? Strong actor.
Right. Right. On that note, keep thinking. I'm trying to get some other ones. We're going to go to a tune I do called I Surrender, back with the Miles Davis days. Ooh. Off of the Say Hello to Hollywood album. You want to hear a tune that rocks like a little R&B? Check it out.
Surrender. Are you happy? Isn't it rich? Are we a me here at last on the ground, you in midair, sending the clouds. Isn't it bliss? Don't you approve? One who keeps tearing around, one who can't move. Where are the clowns? Quick, send in the clowns. Just when I stop opening doors, finally knowing the one that I wanted was yours. Making my entrance again with my usual flair, sure of my lines, no is there. Don't you love farce? My fault, I fear. I thought that you'd want what I'd want. Sorry, my dear. But where are clowns? Send in the clowns. Don't bother, they hear.
Yeah, so Tom, this was sending the clowns, obviously, and this was at the Smith Center. You performed that?
No, this was at Boulder Station with my Las Vegas Rocks variety show. You know, when I wrote the song Las Vegas Rocks, and in 10 years ago,
yeah,
I wrote the song Las Vegas Rocks for my 20th anniversary, and then all of a sudden I'm looking up and I see this clock.
Now is the Las Vegas Rocks on Kistuka? It's on here,
yeah,
and it's on here too.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it's on here too, the full version.
Okay. So let's talk.
So I wrote Las Vegas Rocks in the year 2000, and then. And then I created the clock. Then I created a whole bunch of souvenir line. And then I actually opened up the Las Vegas Rocks Cafe, like the Hard Rock Cafe, another goal of mine. I raised $500,000. And we wind up losing that for, we don't want to get into that.
Okay, is that the one on Fremont Street?
Yes.
Okay, and what was it called?
Las Vegas Rocks Cafe.
Because everyone was looking forward to it, and then I think just a lot of things happened.
Well, we had no air conditioning, so we went out of business, which is okay.
Well, at least you put it out there that's what it is.
But it's really, I think I'm going to try to bring it, bring it back. But anyway, so then after that, I go, you know what? I think let me create a new show. What could I call it? And I said, might as well call it Las Vegas Rocks Variety Show. I own the name, because I was thinking all these different names. I own the name. I trademarked the name. So I produced the Las Vegas Rocks Variety Show, and I interviewed the Nelson Twins. I had Earl Turner came on and sang with me, and the Australian Bee Gees. So it became fun. I had a live band, just like they do on the networks. So it was another goal of mine. I checked that one off, and that lasted 3 years, and then just recently I started producing these variety shows at Ron the Cars Event Center.
Yeah.
I produced 14 of them over there, so I produced almost 50 variety shows.
And we were just talking during the break, and some of the other ones, too, that you produced.
Well, Entertainment Las Vegas Style is my main show.
Right, just give them the list.
Plastic Vegas Entertainment is my new show. It's like American Movie Classics, and I'm repackaging all my old footage It's really exciting.
Okay, so somebody's...
They can watch it Sunday, 11 a.m.
That's what I
need
to know.
On the CW.
That's what
Sunday, 11 a.m. on the CW, and late night, Saturday night, on the NBC affiliate at 3:30 in the morning. And then you could watch my other show, 2 a.m. on the CW, and then you could watch the other shows on Prism, Channel 20, Friday nights at 11 o'clock, Saturdays at 10 o'clock, and then Sundays at 10 o'clock on Prism. So I'm airing, actually... Between Laughlin, Lake Havasu, Pahrump, and Las Vegas, my show airs 19 times in one weekend, and then I air on the Family Network in 50 markets across the country.
That's beautiful, man. That's great. Now, see, if I didn't have to be somewhere, you know, tonight, because you know where I'm going, you're picking up dinner easy, because you're not hurting. You're doing all right. Clock's doing well. Book's doing all right. Tony's sock is doing all right. He's happy.
Reality, okay? Perception is reality. You got to fake it until you make it.
Fake it until you make it. We've heard that. And then, you know, the guy that's, you know, really looking sharp and everything else, maybe he's got a dollar in his pocket. I don't know.
You know, it's not about money. It's not about money. You got to be happy in life. Yes.
I totally agree with you there. So, yes. And singing brings a joy.
It does.
To people as an entertainer doing it. That's the joy
singing,
that I get, yeah. You know.
It really is, especially when audience members come up to you and they say they were touched by that song. That's, as a singer, you can't get a better compliment than you move people with your music.
You got a favorite song? Because I have one. I was just wondering.
Well, yeah, I got a song. It's an original song called "Listen to My Heart." And I have a CD called "Listen to My Heart." It's great.
Okay, but do you have one that's maybe, you know, someone else's song, possibly? You know, that you kind of grew up with it.
I think "Wonderful World" is a great tune that I enjoy singing.
You like Louis Armstrong doing it?
Yeah, and then I like doing the oldies. "In the Still of the Night" is a favorite song of mine.
Yeah, you like the doo-wop stuff. That's cool. That was all around Philly, man. All that stuff, right? Yeah, man, when you were growing up, that whole thing was going on, right?
Yeah, I love that three-part triad harmony.
Right, right.
Yeah. That's a favorite of mine.
Yeah, I'll be hearing that in a little bit, man. The Buckinghams. Nick Fortuno, thank you. We'll be seeing you in a little while over at Rampart on my dad's birthday. It's fantastic.
That's great. Happy birthday, Dad.
Yeah, God bless you, Pop. Would have been 86 today. Carmine, Pistol, Ciccone. You know, rest in peace. What do we got going on, Lawrence? We're talking with Mr. Saka. Yeah, we got a break happening in a little while, right?
7 minutes.
7 minutes. We got a lot of time. We got a lot of time, man.
Let me tell you something.
Yeah, tell us.
When I was on the road... And I tell you, I grew up a little insecure. I was 28 years old, going on 29, and I started reading all this positive philosophy, Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill, Law of Success, W. Clement Stone, Vincent J. Pearl. And they were talking about right brain, left brain. And they said the right brain is the creative and the left brain is the intellect. So I changed my name from Anthony to Tony, and it took me 4 years to become totally left-handed. So now I am a total left-handed person. And I got to tell you, it really opened up the creative side of my brain because I developed my left hand. So I could write with both hands.
Right. Now, are you drinking water there? Is that water?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. All right. I just wanted to check now.
I want to tell people we have to do things sometimes to, you know, grow. And to me, becoming a left-handed person took me 4 years to become totally left-handed.
So now why...
Can you get this hand and go like this, and this hand go like that, like this? Can you ever try that?
Yeah, watch. It goes like this.
No, just like this and that like that.
This one. It's got something to think about, yeah. Why, can you do it?
Oh, yeah.
Nice, man. You play drums, then?
I could play guitar.
Right, I know you play guitar, but now here's the question. Right now they're in the car or at home or at the computer going, well, Joe, ask the question. Do you play left-handed now? Whole nother thing. Why? I'm a guitar player, dude.
I could probably play left-handed if I had a left-handed guitar, because I think my brain would... I could see the chords right now, the way I play the chords on each side.
And that would be trippy, man, if you could. You know what I'm saying? Well, all we do is just take a regular guitar and string it the other way, you know?
Yeah,
I know. Yeah.
But I wish I was a better guitar player, but I could hold my own playing rhythm and backing myself up. And I play piano at home. I got a nice grand piano.
Right, yeah. Fantastic.
So, Yeah, but the right brain left thing was something I like to tell people, give them something to think about.
That was pretty heavy duty. So how about the familia, the mom and dad still around?
I lost my mother November 4th, about 4 years ago.
Yeah.
My dad 20 years ago, my twin brother 14 years ago. I got one sister left.
You have a sister then, okay. Yeah. And her name is?
Marie. She's 5 years older than I am.
Oh, very good. What does she do?
She works down the food market, and she does the administrative in the food market.
Philly?
Yeah.
Cool,
my whole family's in Philly.
I'm the
only one out here.
Now, what do you do like Thanksgiving? Do we have something at the soccer house, or do you
well,
go
you know,
split?
Being married to an internationally acclaimed chef.
She is.
She is an incredible. She does not let me cook. She just don't want me to cook. She loves preparing food like I like singing.
Yeah.
And she'll whip up anything. She's a great cook. I'll tell you something. You'll love this. This is another one. Like if I ask an entertainer about something or producing, you can give me the answer like that because we're experienced. So I said to her, we're having breakfast. I said, Josette, how long does it take to boil an egg? Right?
Right. Can she boil water? But go ahead, okay. Said Joe.
How long does it take to boil an egg? Off the top of her head, because she's an experienced chef, her answer was, it all depends on the temperature of the egg before you put it in the boiling water.
Wow. Now, okay. Hey.
Huh?
Folks.
Is that experience?
Folks, you're hearing it from Tony Saka here. All right. It's the egg, the scientific egg.
That's off the top of her head. That's how good of a chef she is. She thinks food. She thinks herbs. She thinks, and she's a baker. So everything, if you watch the way bread is made, it's a timing thing.
Right.
It is unbelievable. That I watched it bakes, the bread's got to rise. I didn't even know there was a mother bread. You have one that...
Gabish, that's where you get the yeast. That's how, yeah, that's the whole thing. That's the main one, and you go off of that.
So I never knew this stuff, but I don't eat bread. But.
So she had the place over here on Flamingo, and now she's where, if we can ask?
No, she's always had the place in California since 1985.
Can we say the name, Josette?
Yeah, Normandy Bakery.
All right, Normandy Bakery. That's all you got to say. That's all you got to say, because I lived there 25 years. I know it well.
Normandy Bakery.
Yeah.
She's had several of them. She's in the farmer's market now, and she also has the big factory on Jefferson between La Cienega and La Brea. And she has her little Josette's Bistro in her bakery, and she's got croissants. She's got
Now, I thought she was just here. I thought it was just a place over here.
I thought it was, too. I didn't realize that she was as successful as she is when I first met her.
Right.
I thought I was doing her a favor going into her little restaurant and singing for her to find out that she owns her own pate, Normandy pate, it's her. We distribute all over the country. She has her own macaroons.
Josette, we're giving you a big plug here on the Joey Ciccone Show. Ooh. We always look for sponsors, dear. Always looking for sponsors. Lovely seeing you a few years back.
Yes.
We're here with Tony Saka. Shows, music, years and years of entertainment. You know, the stories. You can't even get into it for like 2 hours, you know, between going to sponsors and breaks. But we love having you here, Tom. We want to talk about when we come back here.
You know, I got to tell you,
as
an entertainer, a lot of people feel insecure that maybe they haven't achieved. Look, I never made Wikipedia, so that's okay. You know, I never made it like a Celine Dion or somebody like that.
Right.
But I have been so fulfilled as an entertainer performing all around
you're
the country.
You're fortunate, sure, man.
And the world. So I don't feel insecure right now. And I woke up to that realization that I'm very fulfilled as an entertainer, TV host, TV producer.
And something about Chippendales, I heard, too. We got that picture when we did the research.
Yeah, you know, I've always wanted to be a Chippendale.
It's true.
So my friend Adam Steck, who owns Thunder from Down Under,
Australians.
I asked him if they can come on my show, my 50th anniversary show.
We're going to pick that story up because right now I'm visioning you with, you know, the Chippendale things. It's a little scary. We're going to pick it right back up with Tony Saka. You're with Joey Ciccone. The way it is. We'll be right back.
Your show. I really appreciate it. We enjoyed having you on our show last week at Carmine's, the mussels were delicious. You were a great guest.
Well, thanks, Tony, but that's what it's about, you know, just, you know, sharing the love. And the bottom line is people finding out, you know, a little bit more possibly what you're
about.
So
let me tell you about the Thunder from Down Under. So
okay, yeah, here it is now. We were there, and it was a scary thought in my mind, but
no,
go
here
ahead.
It is now. You know, I'm going to dance with Thunder. These guys are 30 years old. I'm 30 years older than them. So I spent 90 days working out. Worked out, and I built my muscles up. You know, if you work out 90 days heavy, you could build up your muscles.
Yeah.
So when I went to go practice with them at the Excalibur, the PR lady said, you know, Tony, don't worry about it. We got these fake muscles that we'll put on you.
The stuff that, yeah, right.
Right.
After so, breaking your ass for
so
90 days.
They didn't know that I was going to look like I looked when I took my shirt off, you know. And you see the pictures of me and these young kids up there. It's unbelievable. And I was 63 at the time, and these guys are only 28, 29, and 30. And I danced with them, and I was probably the oldest Thunder from Down Under guy.
Right. Did you make any tips that night? That's what they want to know, man.
Yeah. No, I didn't get any tips.
Man, you got a tip on a horse or maybe a phone number or something?
No tips. No
All
tips.
All right. So that was Down Under. We got to talk about, you know, because time goes fast, man. You know, I just like right now it'd be nice to have a little cocktail and chat. But San Gennaro, what's going on with that?
San Gennaro is a 36-year tradition. This was the first year. It normally was once a year, and then about 5-6 years ago, we started doing twice a year. But he had some kind of location problem. So we did May, but we didn't do September. And I talked to Mr. Pomisano, and he says, we're actually going to do one in Florida in March.
Mm, yeah.
And then we're going to do one again in May here.
Right.
So, and he asked, you know, so...
Does he still live out there in Florida?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, he moved to Rhode Island.
Oh, okay.
He moved to Rhode Island. So I talked to him. We're going to be doing San Gennaro again. But, you You know, again, you know, in our as being an entertainer, independent contractor, you know, that was a good job for me. It didn't happen in September. That's fine. You just got to keep reinventing yourself.
And do you feel like through all these years, man, you've been able to do that? Or, I mean, you know, you sit there and you come up with an idea.
You got to keep reinventing yourself.
Right. You come up with it, like you were saying, you came up with this idea. And okay, now I got to try this. So I'm going to go this way.
Yeah,
if it doesn't work sometime, right?
Yeah.
You don't give up, right?
You
try something else, right?
A hockey player once said, out of 100 shots not taken, none will score.
I love it, man. It's the same with the bat. I mean, you know, if you're not going to swing, come on, man.
You'll never hit the ball.
And by the way, man, you know, the Mets, I was going for you. You know, I was born in Brooklyn, but Chicago I was raised in. Then you beat Chicago, and then this happens? Don't even get me started, all right? The Royals deserved it, and my hat's off to the Royals. Fantastic job.
Yeah.
Let's talk a little bit about without naming names, there's got to be some people you've come across in our business that maybe, you know, didn't work out too well. I don't want to, you never want to badmouth anyone, but I mean,
no,
I've worked on the set in L.A. for 25 years, and I could tell you something.
Yeah, I don't know. Out of the 30 years, I don't think I had a bad interview with anybody.
I'm not just saying interview, but I'm saying people you've come across, you know. How about back in the day? Let's just go back there. Obviously, were things different in your mind from how they are today?
In Vegas?
Yes.
Well, a lot of people say Vegas isn't the way it was.
I'm the first to say it.
Yeah, but I would say, how much hay do you have in your yard to feed your horse?
Right. Well, first, I don't have a horse, but...
Right. You don't have a horse because things have changed since then. So you got to go with changing. Look, phones, computers, everything changes.
So right, because before when you'd be like on a radio show and your phone rang, you wouldn't answer it. But now since it's changed, you answer the phone.
I am so glad I came to Vegas when I did in 81 because I don't think I'd be where I am today in Vegas with the television show and all the people that I've met and opportunity, my production company. I also have a full-service advertising agency. I produce TV commercials for people. I place media. That's been another mainstream of my income, being a advertisement agency doing press releases, because I have a company called Vegas Media and I do press releases on me and press releases on all my clients. So that is another thing that I enjoy doing. I love producing television commercials and concepts and creative. I'm doing it right now called Smiles Today Dental, and he's getting a lot of airtime. And I borrowed the jingle. When you're smiling, at Smiles Today Dental, we have braces for all ages, teeth whitening.
That's good. That's my new my other new sponsor right now. So it's beautiful. It's fantastic.
It's my sponsor.
Thank you.
It's been
a sponsor. Good. Throw a bone over here.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you can't use that tune. You got to pay for the rights to use that melody.
Well, yeah, you got to. It's not that expensive.
I know.
It's not that expensive.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, it's not. But anyways, I got an advertising agent. I got a full service production company, TV shows, and I'm a performer. So I got a lot of things going on.
You're busy. You got a lot going on. Will you be out here for the holidays or?
I think I'm going to be in California with my lady for Thanksgiving.
Very nice.
And Christmas will probably be in L.A.
Yeah.
You know, you have 25 years of L.A. I'm just getting introduced to L.A.
Oh, you love it, Tone. Yeah. It's like you out here, man, you know.
Yeah.
I wasn't out here all the time. You were, and I was there in Chicago and back east. So it's like, oh, you'll love it, bro. It's the best town, man. But I know all the places you mentioned, all those restaurants, the bread place. Please, it's incredible.
She's done well for herself as a baker, as a food manufacturer, as a chef, very well respected.
Right.
Chef. She's getting an award from the French government, the honors, top honors, the merit of honor for her outstanding achievement as a French chef.
Right. Well, listen. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna wrap things up. I want to tell you that.
Already?
Yeah, see, man.
Oh, my God.
Time goes fast. And
wow, I can't believe we've done 2 hours.
2 hours we did today. Yeah, man, you know, between everything. But you know what? I hope you got to find out, friends, some things about Tony maybe that you didn't know. You know, people like to judge real fast, but sometimes when you really find out really what the person's about, you know, a little bit, maybe take a different look at the person. So, you know, keep that in mind. That's why I was asking some of these questions. They're good questions, and maybe there's some things that if someone was interviewing me, I would kind of like. So listen, every Friday, you'll catch me here. Don't move the camera, don't do nothing, but this lady to my left is Miss Helen Carr. She has managed me for a year, and we are business partners in a company called the Green Cat Ventures. Venture stands for all of the above. Got a book and a movie that's we're wheeling and dealing. The movie and the movie I've been working on really hard. It's a life story. Anyway, Joey Ciccone with you with the show, The Way It Used to Be and The Way It Is. My guest today, Tony, what can I say?
Thank you. Thank you.
From the bottom of my heart, Kumbadi. Ciao. I wish you health and success, and it's beautiful. Thank you for the clock. Tony gave me the clock and the book. Maybe, I don't know, maybe Helen gets the stuffed animal. Just an idea. Animal, yeah. Just an idea, you know, because I got to hear it later, like, you got stuff? No.
She gets Vegas Vinny.
We love you all. I want to thank my crew, John and Lawrence. And now we're going to have a little pink box, which my new sponsor. We're going to get in the box, and we're going to just mangiare a little bit, okay? We love you. Joey Ciccone. And love is a tender trap.
La, la, la.
Tony Sacca, Joey Ciccone. We'll see you next week, Friday at 4.